Colts, and this is Monday Night Football on EA Sports. Ahead, we'll see the runner-up and Rookie of the Year balloting Baker Mayfield and the Cleveland Browns as they take on Jacoby Brissett and the Indianapolis Colts. With that, let's get on up to Lucas Oil Stadium in Indianapolis. For the call, we bring in our broadcasters, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, we are pleased as always to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Just a short time ago, smoke from the pyrotechnics filled the dome as the Colts made their way out of the locker room. We're set for football as the Colts get set to match up with the Cleveland Browns. Happy to be on hand. I'm Brandon Godden with Charles Davis. And before we kick, partner, your keys to the game, please.
Well, my keys are on the defensive side of the ball for both teams. And the big one, making sure you avoid giving up the big play. These safeties are going to get tested all game long. Their job, keep the ball in front of them, tackle people, make them run extra plays in order to try and score.
Here's the punter, Rigoberto Sanchez, on to get us started. And off we go on EA Sports. That'll be taken in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was, as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line.
Time to get our first look at the Browns offense, led by quarterback Baker Mayfield. And the Browns now at 4-6, two wins in a row. And Baker Mayfield in the last win against Pittsburgh, although he was only around 50% throwing the ball, Charles, two touchdowns and no interceptions.
And that was the key. Took care of the football, because turnovers have been a problem for he and the Browns throughout the season. But how about how he handled himself post-game? After the controversy on the field, how he spoke, I thought he was eloquent. I thought he was to the point. But he spoke as a member of the NFL more than he spoke as a member of the Cleveland Browns. And I thought his comments were absolutely perfect for the moment.
Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. Landry, the intended target, and that'll bring up second down. Let's meet the offense, Greg Robinson. Very, very talented.
What a man to set your offensive line with. Greg Robinson can do it all. Tremendous athleticism, great strength, just coming into his own.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Throwing, Mayfield, eluding the pressure right. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third. And now a look at the defense for the Colts.
Justin Houston is truly one of the elite pass rushers in the league. Knows how to get to the quarterback with a variety of moves.
So now an early 3rd and 10 here on their opening drive. Play fake. Mayfield, they'll roll him out right. And now another one thrown incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
And take it right on the 30. Well done on the return. And this offense takes over in great shape right at the 50, 1st and 10. Jacoby Brissett bringing out the Indianapolis Colts, who sit at 6-4 right now. Brissett in the week 11 win over Jacksonville, the game the Colts needed. Threw for 148 yards, a touchdown, and an interception. So the number's not great, but good to see him back out there after Brian Hoyer had been the quarterback the previous couple of weeks.
The only number they cared about was the number that put him in the win column, because that's what they needed. As you mentioned, they'd had two straight losses, and now they head into a big game with the Houston Texans, and they have their leader back, and that's Jacoby Brissett. That team just has so much more confidence when he's on the field.
Just like that, a pickup of 20 on their first play from scrimmage. So 1st and 10 now from the 30. On play action, Brissett. Dancing to his left. Now he'll pull it down.
He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down. And here are the Colts offensive starters.
Brian Kelly's a great example of how valuable centers have become in the NFL. A former first-round pick, he was plugged in immediately to be a starter, to handle big nose tackles as well as blitzing linebackers, and also able to move and get out into the run game and get to the second and third level and deliver blocks.
Now a quick throw as that's complete on the hitch route. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Paris Campbell, 26 yards. And they are able to strike first here on their opening drive. An ideal start for them, really. You force the punt, and then you go down and score.
And you've got to see a fist pump on the sideline from the head coach, don't you? Because he's turning to his bench, and he's telling his team, this is how we prepare. Force the punt, go downfield and score. I told you guys, it's just like a boxer in the gym preparing for the fight. Now we get to turn it all loose.
Now Adam Vinatieri for the point after. And this is good to make it 7-0 Indy.
Roughing the kicker, defense.
Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Football going back to the Cleveland Browns here. I want to step back and just look at where they are on their season. We mentioned earlier that they're 4-6 now after a two-game winning streak. And despite the controversy in week 11 that we all know about, look, they're 2-0 against AFC North opponents. Could they make a push here for the playoffs, CD?
Isn't it interesting how in the beginning of the season so many people have been going to the Super Bowl, which I did not buy into at all, as you might remember. But at the same time, everyone is burying them now. But they do have a chance because their schedule. It's one of the lightest ones in the NFL to close the regular season. If they can keep winning and get a little outside help, they might still be in the wild card race. Look at this. They host Miami next. Then they're at Pittsburgh. Then home against Cincinnati. What did you mention about them in the division? Undefeated so far.
Yeah, 2-0, and you're right. Gosh, you got to think hosting Miami, that's a good look. Home for Cincy, that's a good look. Two of the next three, maybe three of the next three, a real possibility. Plays like we just saw there, that's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs who are putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out, because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game. And that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Mayfield now. He can run for it, and he will. And he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide. And they'll get him to the ground. He has another first down at the Colts 23.
When they watch film of this game and hand out the grade sheets, he's going to really like getting a double plus on this play. Why? He scrambles and picks up a first down. But what else does he do? Protects himself by sliding and avoiding the big hit. Double plus, big time play.
Chubb on first down, no room to roam as he struggles just to get back to the line of scrimmage. It was Matthew Adams who got him down on the defensive side. Looking to throw on second down. Mayfield. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Back at the 26-yard line. Margus Hunt able to drop him for a loss of a couple.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and they can often hit big, but sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly. And the pressure gets to him again.
What's up about teams are so competitively matched, and you just want to make those plays that give you an advantage? How about right here? The difference between letting them score a touchdown versus holding them to a field goal, that's absolutely huge with the play he just made.
And you know he hated taking the loss there on third down. So as it turns out, that sack doesn't wind up costing them, Charles. They at least get points, get three of them.
Yeah, that's where your kicker can really come to your rescue, because you know after the sack, there was a little consternation there. Are we out of field goal range? Are we going to be able to get three? In this case, he stepped right up and gave them exactly what they needed.
And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. The Indy offense at the line and set to go. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Well, the first play of the drive lost four. Now they'll look to move it forward here on second and 14. And he's going to keep it here. And he'll slide down to avoid the contact. After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. Throw here, finding Pascal. And the result here, a pickup of eight. Leaves him with two to go on second down. Facing a second and two after that last catch. Good for 8 yards. Off the play fake. Here's Brissett. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one. And it's third down.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion, kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you can go make a play on the football.
Brissett on third and two. And he's got his man, Hilton. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. Hilton's first catch, good for a first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
They go play action with Brissett. Escaping the pressure right. He's going to take off with it. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard. Looking to throw again on second down. Brissett. This will be play number 7 on the drive. 3rd and a yard. Brissett now. Taken in by the tight end Doyle. And he takes this one in for a Colts touchdown. Jack Doyle, 30 yards. And the Colts, they add on to their advantage. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. Vinatieri now to tack on the PAT. And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. So that one, an 8-play drive. It spans 75 yards. And it culminates in an Indianapolis touchdown. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. They trail now 14-3, an 11-point deficit as they start things out with a 1st and 10. Mayfield going to lead the Browns up now 1st and 10 at their own 17-yard line. Play action now. Here's Mayfield. Flushed out right. It won't be a sack, but it's no gain, and it brings up second down.
Well, there was pressure all around him, so the only play was to try and get out of there. I think it was an excellent effort by him just to get back to the line of scrimmage.
To throw again on second down. Mayfield forced out to his left. That's complete to Demetrius Harris, the tight end. And mark him down way up close to the 40 at the 39. 22 yards there, a first down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Here's Mayfield. He's got a first down and then some at midfield. And all the way down to the 33-yard line. That'll wind up a gain of 27 on the catch and run.
I know you're trying not to scoreboard watch, but you only got 3 points. You're kind of hoping that that type of play there gives you some positive momentum going into the half.
Yeah, need to do something to get more than that 3 number that they have on the scoreboard right now. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. And now the third down throw incomplete as well.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, as it turned out. Couldn't even find his outlet, man, because of the coverage. It's way too tight. Unable to find anyone open. A 52-yard attempt.
And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. And a second field goal here cuts their deficit to 14-6 now. These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny? When we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were all-state quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. Now, right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. 2 drives, 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. That one goes for 30 yards. Brissett. And the catch made by Hilton. Well, that certainly changes things.
Yeah, I think the thought process is they take this lead into the locker room, run something simple here and run the clock out. Instead, they get the big play. Now they have a chance to increase.
And oh, his first carry, he loses the football. And this is picked up by the Browns. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Mayfield now after the fumble recovery. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. The Pro Bowler Odell Beckham, the intended receiver. But it's going to be second down. All right, CD, let's look ahead to week 12, the week before Thanksgiving. Hard to believe some big games. It started Thursday night, Colts-Texans, to decide who would go ahead in that division. But also Seahawks-Eagles, a game that you're going to be doing. That's a big one.
It's a monster one. And if you look at the Eagles' record, you would think they absolutely have to have it. But in the NFC East, even a loss doesn't eliminate them. But if they win, they can be neck and neck with Dallas. With Seattle, they're trying to keep pace and stay right on the heels of San Francisco in the NFC West. How about Dallas at New England? That's a big-time game. The Cowboys trying to maintain their lead in the NFC East. New England just one loss, and Green Bay.
It got his man complete. Now the Browns will use the first of their 3 timeouts. As it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number one. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. And again, it's Mayfield. Hit from behind, and he's going to be driven down. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Mayfield steps away to his left. Now he'll let it go on the run. Deep left side. And this is going to wind up incomplete. The coverage there too strong on the deep ball, and now they face a third down. But he's been the guy already over 100 yards here in the first half. Could have had a lot more if he would have been able to haul that one in.
Yeah, in fact, our statistician Marvin was already handing me a piece of paper with that yardage totaled on it. He thought that catch was going to happen just as you and I did as well.
Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete. So it doesn't look like they're going to be able to build off the turnover.
Well, the defense certainly did its part. It got them the football. But you're exactly right. It looks like they're going to have to punt this one away. And it's not a turnover, but doesn't it feel like one after grabbing the momentum with the defensive play?
Yeah, and they had all that momentum after getting the football, and now zapped right back in the other direction. Sliding out of the pocket. He's going to run, but he's got a long way to go. What a real head scratcher there. And that will force a turnover on downs. The Indy offense at the line and set to go. Time for a final kneel down or a safe run, and then they can head to the locker room with a lead.
Yeah, or they can even run a screen. You know, something they feel is somewhat safe that might actually pop and turn into a big play. That's what you usually run in this situation.
Or go four verticals, because why not?
Because you're feeling it, right? You're just feeling it.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. So they saw the contact before the ball arrived. Penalty flag for pass interference.
And trying to avoid pass interference is so difficult. You're trying to slow down these skilled receivers, and somehow, some way, they make plays on the football, and sometimes you're there too soon.
So we are at halftime here on a Monday night as we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome, everyone, to this abridged version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This one has been a hard-hitting affair to this point, and you gotta expect we'll see more of the same in the second half. And to bring the action your way, let's get it right back out to Brandon Godden.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Second half ready to get underway. The Colts with a lead, and they will receive the football. That's fielded in the end zone. And now look at him go. Past the 20, 10, touchdown, Indianapolis. That kickoff return, 104 yards. And the Colts, they add on to their advantage. Always important to get the first score of the second half. Now you start to pull away a little bit and get some breathing room going.
And now we find out about the fortitude of the group that's behind, because they were counting on getting into the game a little bit more, right? Maybe they get the first score. That doesn't happen. It looks almost insurmountable, but it's not. Let's see how hard they play the rest of the game.
So now the other return teams out there, as they'll try to duplicate what they just saw. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line.
Let's go.
Beckham and the Browns set to take over again. And I know that they've double-teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. And how many times have we done games where we've seen a guy have a big game like this? But it's usually not by himself, is it?
Right.
Usually it opens it up for other people to have big games as well. You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game, because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. Demetrius Harris, the intended target. And that'll bring up second down. And with that, folks, I want to remind you to join the NFL Salute to Service. This season, the NFL and its players are honoring those who proudly serve our country. And fans are encouraged to join NFL players in writing letters to service members and their families. To learn how you can send your letter today, visit NFL.com/salute. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
Regular.
Mayfield with it once more. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. Justin Houston, his second sack of the night.
Looks like another empty possession here, partner. And I don't think, with three scores down in the third quarter, they can truly afford any more the rest of the way.
No, especially the way their offense is sputtering. I think you're exactly right. They got to find some answers quickly. This will be fielded at the 17. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Colts will go on offense here, first and 10. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Now how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. On second down now, it's Mack. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. That's good for an Indianapolis first down on a gain of 10.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop him. Flush to his right. He's got Jack Doyle. And oh, he sheds a tackle. Now he's got some space. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. 39 yards the distance covered on the catch and run. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. They run with Hines. And he takes this one in for a Colts touchdown. Taking it in from 11 yards out. And the Colts, they add on to their advantage.
We know that the big guys won't get the credit, Brandon, but we also know that that touchdown belongs to them. Excellent job of clearing the way for their running back.
Terry now for the point after. And they open the lead up now to 25 points. A drive there of just four plays. And in the end, the finishing touch, an 11-yard run. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. The Browns drive about to get started. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working, and call more of that.
Throwing again, Mayfield on second and 10. Buying time to his left. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. The intended receiver was Rashard Higgins, and it's third down. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Mayfield to throw it. Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted, thrown back across his body. Picked up by the rookie from Temple, Rocky Sin. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. From the gun, here's Brissett. Middle of the field to the tight end, Doyle. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there are more people there to get him down.
And he'll go down at the 28. The improvisation gets him only a couple, but that's all he needed. First down. Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. This is Hines. And an alley to run. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and 4.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Play fake. Brissett. He'll find Hines out of the backfield. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. On first down, Hines. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. Back now in Indianapolis. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number 4. Second and 5 now. Brissett, that's complete to Hines out of the backfield. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. Call it a gain of 3, and they're going to have a third down. Third and short yardage, Brissett. And that is caught. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Zach Pascal, a touchdown on a kick return, and now one through the air as his guys continue to pour it on. So another score there. Often you talk about the three phases of the game, defense, offense, special teams. It's been a clean sweep in this one, hasn't it?
It certainly has. They've been pretty dominant throughout this game. And privately, the head coach will add a fourth phase. That's the coaching, and he'll tell the ownership that as he tries to negotiate a new contract off of this win.
They are looking strong here in the fourth quarter. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. Now the Browns offense, they get ready to head back onto the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Eluding the pressure right. And now he's going to use his legs. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's second down.
Well, he's proven real effective running the football. No one open, don't force it. Just get what you can, and that's what he's done very well in this game.
Throwing again on second down, Mayfield. The Colts are gonna get him, down he goes.
That right now, that's a defeated team out there. I think you can see it totally in their body language.
Hands on hips, heads low. It's just been a struggle from the start.
Yeah, this team has been thoroughly beaten right from the word go.
He finds Beckham complete. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. Odell Beckham, 69 yards. And the Browns make some inroads here on that deficit. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions, and I'd hear 9 from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
Following the touchdown, here's Seibert now to kick it off. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. We've got a lopsided game here. I don't know, Charles, what does the handbook say that we discuss when we've got a game like this in the fourth quarter?
Hold on a second. Let me thumb.
And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. And this is picked up by the Browns. often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations, big time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
The Indy offense at the line and set to go. The outcome of this one, well, we know who's going to win it. It's just all window dressing at this point. Got me thinking, what's the biggest blowout that you've been a part of as a player, broadcaster?
No, I'm not going to go to the player part because when I think blowout.
Because you won every game as a player.
No. I think about being blown out. And no one wants to go back to those memories. But, you know, when I was calling college football, I saw a game that, you know, team put 70. I actually saw it happen twice. A team put 70 on their opponent. And in the NFL in the 2017 season, I saw one of those changing of the guard games where a team that hadn't been very good before.
Blitz coming and down he goes. So the Colts in possession of the football as we get your reset. They've got a second down now as they look to salt this one away. On second down, it's Hines. So from second and long, now we go to third and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in four down territory.
And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
There's no doubt in my mind.
And do you hear that? Do you hear the?
It's not scales, right? I don't hear scales. Do I actually hear a tune being warbled?
I think the fat lady's humming.
Yeah, she's doing more than humming. She's belting it out right now.
She's full bore.
Yeah, this thing is flat out finished.
The Colts going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. Now this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. So that drive, four plays. And the finishing touch was that nice long run into the end zone. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. Heading out is the Cleveland offense now as they get set to take over here. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest.
Don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Yeah, use that as ammo
exactly.
Going forward.
Exactly. Take a great look at that scoreboard. Realize how poorly everything went for us today. Coaching, playing, the whole deal. And never forget it because
you're not going to want that feeling
no,
again.
No, you don't want that feeling again. And who knows? You may meet up with this team again.
To throw, Mayfield. And that'll wind up incomplete. Trying to give his man room to run under it, but it's second down. Another incompletion. You know, it's a wonder he's still moving around back there the number of times he's been sacked.
Yeah, he's staying out there, isn't he? And you don't think about it much in a game like this, but he's showing incredible leadership. Still competing, still fighting.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
The has been a tough one for this offensive line. It appears almost like they've been on roller skates this entire game, the way they've been pushed around. Six sacks given up in this one.
Mayfield and this Browns offense staring at a third and long now after the sack. Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect. Well, the trials and tribulations of being a quarterback in this league, it's tough. It's got to be wearing on him out there.
Well, he has been sacked a number of times. He had an interception, so I'm going to give him a skosh of credit for hanging in there and trying to make something happen, despite the amount of pressure he's been under this entire game.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and now possession will go over inside the 15-yard line. So they tried to go for it for pride, but it really wouldn't have mattered. This one, it was already determined.
No doubt about it. This one was over a while ago.
Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and two.
Let's go.
They run again with Hines. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Not too many more ideal situations at second and two in order to try and pick up a first down. They ran it and picked it up.
Well, they probably don't need to run a play here, but you wonder if they're going to be able to resist on first and goal. Looking to run with Mack, and they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals. I tell you, Charles, you play to the final whistle, I get that, but there are a few folks that might not be too happy with that score late in the game with it already well in hand.
You seem a little squeamish about that last score.
I struggle with it. I struggle. But on the other, the argument, I get it, on the other side is, hey, do something about it. Stop them.
I guarantee you, I know who was really excited. Fantasy owners who had them. Hey, listen, getting the points for me, they're not worried about hurt feelings or anything like that. That's just new age stuff.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was, as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. And what are the whistles for? Timeout. So they'll stop the clock here in a game that's been decided in the closing seconds.
Big series right here. We got to step it up.
Mayfield now looking to throw on first down. It's caught. Beckham. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job.